Samuel Lovey is my name. I'm a designer craftsman. And what I mean by designer craftsman is, I usually work in clay. And working in clay started in the year 1977-78, when I was in Glasgow, Scotland. I got to Scotland not even knowing where I was going after passing my exams at the British Council, and I was given the scholarship to go to UK. When I got to Scotland, I got to realize that I was in Glasgow. And Glasgow is one of the best city centers in Scotland. So I got myself in Glasgow School of Art, which was my first choice. And originally, I was going to go into drawing and painting department when one of my lecturers called me and said, looking at my background, clay or ceramic would be the best department for me to be in because I'm from Africa and the materials there are there for me to be using instead of being a painter or having difficulty in getting a job. So I found myself in the ceramic department. This was in 1978-79. So since then I moved out from the tutorship of one of my lecturers called Danny Ferguson to Dougie Davis and Alec Lecky, who are in charge of the ceramic department. So I was with them for 4 years, and after graduating, I left for postgraduate course in St. Andrew College of Education for me to have a practical experience in teaching what I learned. So I spent a year in St. Andrew College of Education by learning how to teach art. I enjoyed that quite a lot, and after that I have to leave for Ghana to practice what I've learned. So in 1986 I moved down back home and started practicing with the Department of Rural Housing and Cottage Industry, which was then at the Okponglo, which was formerly known as the Old Brigade. And when I was there, I was working under one Mr. Oben. And this Oben too was a contractor by profession, so he doesn't know much about ceramics. So I realized that I was just wasting myself and my time in doing what I was doing by then. So one day I just called the head and then told him that no, I want to go home. And they couldn't believe what I was saying. I said, I want to go home and then do what I wanted to do. And they were all looking at me. I said, you Mr. Lovey, people are looking for a job and you've got the job and you want to leave. But they don't know that if a blind man say he's going to throw a stone, the stone must be under his feet. So I just opt out of the department. And that was in 1991. So since 1991, I was in the house practicing what I'm doing up till now. Yes, so that is how the whole thing started after leaving the Department of Rural Housing and Cottage Industry. And ceramic work or clay work is not without any hurdles. You see, there were some hurdles on the way because I wasn't fully prepared before I entered the ceramic. I was doing open firing, you see, which I learned from the village women when I was with Rural Housing and Cottage Industry. I was working with the women of Agomeda, Doyum, Kodiaben, and Dodowa. So I was working with all these women because I took interest in what they were doing. When I went around to see what they were doing, and one thing I like about them is that they were doing what they were taught since from the time immemorial. But when I pick samples from them and then brought it home, I realized that what they have been doing could be developed and be exported. So I got in touch with these women. I went to the chief of Agomeda. Then I asked them to bring all the women together in the chief's house so that we could talk. So in the presence of the chief, I told the women that I'm interested in what they were doing and I'm willing to develop their work for export. Really, it came true. My dream came true and they were also happy. I went to Doyum. I did the same thing and the women too also responded well. I came to Kodiaben. The Kodiaben women too also did very well. So I was really enjoying what I was doing by then. You see, and since then, I just said to myself, I will never look for government work anymore. Because since 1991, if I could employ the youth, I was having over 20 young men to be assisting me. I was having women, over 100 women to work with. You see, I went across the Volta. There is a village called Amedeka. One person, that's what it means. Amedeka, that's the name of the village. And then there was another village to call Togome. That is beyond the Akusi River, the Volta River. I went there too, we became friendly. So all I did was adding value to what they've been doing and then bringing them home and then adding color and sending them out. That is how I continued the whole work with the women. And there was a time during this Osama bin Laden time, everything came to a halt. Everything came to a halt. The people were afraid of coming back into the country, and export since then wasn't the same export it used to be anymore. Yes, but we are managing. I know there are some step backs in the field of ceramic, because ceramic is becoming more competitive. You see, there are a lot of people coming into the ceramic. So the best way to try your strength is to go out and meet people outside the country by competing with them to see where you stand. So I used to go out to Burkina Faso to meet all that ceramics from all over Africa. So I became, I took the second position in the whole of Africa, and I was given a huge sum of money as an award, which I've been asked to come and pick in Paris. So after Paris, I went, been given another chance to travel around France. That was the French embassy also gave me another opportunity of traveling around France to see what the French designers are also doing. So the French designers were also pleased to meet me, and we chat and we organize a workshop and an exhibition as well. And everything went well in France. So later on, UNESCO sent me also to Mexico to go and meet other designers from all over the world in Mexico. And it was great. It was a great opportunity that was open to me. I met a lot of people, we became friends and all that. So I went on by going to Ivory Coast, which is La Côte d'Ivoire. I went there and went in for another competition, and I won there too. You see, I was given another award in Côte d'Ivoire, which was very good. So now the people of Côte d'Ivoire really admire what I do to the highest level, that when I get to Côte d'Ivoire, they give me all that I need. Yes, So the same thing I was also, the same thing happened to me in the Netherlands. And the Netherlands embassy also invited me to the Netherlands to come and exhibit in Den Haag Museum. And that exhibition too was quite successful. Yes, so after that, I had an exhibition in Togo, yes, which was also very nice. See, so since then, I've been going to Côte d'Ivoire. You see, so Côte d'Ivoire is now becoming a place where I feel so comfortable with other designers in La Côte d'Ivoire. The best, in my case, personally, I do it at my own demand. Yes, if I mean demand, what I mean is when I get the inspiration of creating something, yes,